Blessed and highly favored, and I hope y'all are too.
Good. You know, once we get that 3 million out there,
y'all know, there's a process between cleaning the money, and then there's a process between.
We wouldn't know, we wouldn't know.
The cameras are rolling.
So is there anything else?
While you're sitting in the precinct, yeah. That's tough. He's not here. Yeah.
What does that other word, right?
He's not in here.
Okay.
And if you come on my property without a warrant, then yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's when they cut the next scene and you see the nigga in jail like that. Right, in jail already.
Yeah, it was a big yeah.
I would have just let you keep going.
Yeah, I'm pretty much ready.
And if you come in here without my permission,
Lordy Lord,
then just know.
All right, everybody. Welcome to the 804 Podcast. I'm Nick.
Jesse.
Alex.
And today we have Diamond with us.
Diamond Chanel. Yeah. Wishing him well.
What's up?
Yes, I'm so happy to be here. I've heard about y'all's podcast for a minute, seen some of my friends on here, and I've decided, you know, I really want to talk to y'all, see what this is all about.
I guess since my boy Alex be out and about, Diamond, one thing, if you have seen the show, one thing you already know, Alex is not the best with comedy episodes.
It'd be kind of tough.
Show after show. It'd be kind of tough.
It'd be kind of tough.
We blame Chesterfield County.
First, I look to the camera. Nobody's behind the camera, so I'm by myself. I look to my brother Nick, by myself on an island. Look to my brother Jesse.
No more left doings.
Okay. All right.
Maybe you.
We don't know. 300, maybe?
If I had to take a wild guess in the dark, just a wild guess, I mean, didn't even know. I want to say me and my good brothers have been doing the 804 podcast for 223 episodes.
Ooh. Nice. Wow.
Your boy. Your boy.
You always got to make sure, Diamond. That's yes. Right. Because everything's so sound, but you got to make sure.
Wow. Back I was checking, so close to being number 222. That would have been
two.
Perfect. But this is 111. So, hey, still got that angel number.
Yeah.
I'm weak.
3 divided by.
So, when did I get my diploma? Yeah, it's like.
A quote of the week, quote of the day. And this quote can be a song lyric, Bible verse, tattoo, IG caption, just anything that means something to you, anything that you live life by.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, I'll just do the one that I wrote down today.
Talk to us.
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Period.
Of course.
That's the energy for this new moon in Capricorn, reminding ourselves that we can do anything. Like, there's no limit. Any limitations is just in our mind. But through Christ, anything is possible, even miracles. So,
God is
young people still cool with God in 2024?
I hope so. They need to be because the enemy is out. Target the youth and to get them distracted away from God. And I remember when I was a teenager, when I stopped praying and when I started falling asleep in church, everything went downhill. So I'm coming back to God, coming back to the truth, especially because, as you know, I am a spiritual being, but I feel like when I was in the world, I wasn't fully connected to God. I was a little too open-minded, so I had to, you know, close that third eye a little bit. Just stay focused on the truth, because there's a lot of illusions out here and deception.
I've never heard a spiritual person kind of break it down like that, because they always try to separate it.
Right, it's two different things, but it's the same source.
So it's sounding like everybody should just do them in mind they dead off at this, but just put God up in there and you are. Exactly. Everybody's good. But
God into the crystals, the tarot, like you can still do it, but just remember who is the ultimate divine power. And everybody believes what they want. This is just where I am on this journey. So, yes.
That's dope. For sure. You kind of try to push that this year, like, yeah, well, close the end of the year, man.
Yeah.
Can't forget. But, I guess we can go ahead and get the questions going, real quick, just general. If you could tell the people, if they've been living under a rock, no pun intended, you know what I mean? What it is, I knew you were catching eventually, right? The bus was coming. It is coming. I guess real quick, if you could tell the people what it is that you do and everything in detail, I guess, for a little bit.
What do I do? Mm-hmm. Well, let's start with the basics.
Mm-hmm. Broad question, right?
I blink.
Mm.
I eat. All right, no, let's be for real.
Who was rocking with you?
For real, I am a multifaceted artist. Mm-hmm. The different art forms that I do, I sing, I write and speak spoken word poetry, I write my own lyrics, I have started creating beats, so hey, guess you can call me a producer from BandLab. And what else do I do? I wrap crystal jewelry, handmade crystal jewelry. Got my own business, Diamonds Crystals. Make these earrings, make this necklace. Starting to make crowns and candles and things like that. And today I even uploaded a meditation video. So I'm starting to do more like voice acting, just using my voice. And I know how to draw and paint as well. So hey. I mean, Picasso is my birthday twin, so anything art-related, honestly, I forgot my main job as well. I just put in my 2 weeks today, but for the past 1.5 years, I've been a research assistant. I'm free. I'm free from the shackles of the 9-to-5, because I really need to be doing my art full-time. Like, that's what I care about and I'm most passionate about, but I'm also passionate about mental health, too, so... I'm actually licensed as a qualified mental health professional in training. So I'll be working with children who have mental health problems and trying to expose them to like art therapy and just getting out the house, getting into some good, healthy behaviors and stuff. So yeah. How did I forget? I also podcast, audio editing, radio broadcasting with WRAR 97.3 FM Richmond. Like, Written in the Stars is my podcast. I've been podcasting for a minute, but I just love talking and like connecting with people. So, thank y'all.
Some bullet points.
Like, for real. Oh, how did I forget modeling? Hey. Yes. Yeah. For real. I also play my kalimba. Y'all want to see it?
I do.
This is my kalimba, y'all.
What's she pulling?
Everything got quiet.
That's a clip, too.
I would never hurt y'all. But I just be playing a piano. I don't know if you can hear it, but yeah, I just be playing it and it soothes me.
That's real fucking bars right there. Y'all niggas don't be right.
Y'all don't know nothing about that.
Hold on. Y'all know about it.
Yeah.
No, y'all really don't.
Y'all don't know about it.
I'll say this. Out of all the things you listed, which one is the hardest to do?
I would say as far as the hardest, I mean, I would say as an entrepreneur, just it really takes a lot. It takes all your effort to be an entrepreneur. So balancing getting my education, like my bachelor's in psychology, balancing a full-time job and balancing all my other endeavors, it has been hard to like just build this empire that I want. Because basically being a jack of all trades or jack of many trades, like, it can be hard to just focus on one thing, but I feel like that's the thing that will bring me revenue, like my own creation bringing revenue. So that's ultimately what I want to do and why I quit my job, because I feel like I just want to be an entrepreneur and not just work for other people, honestly.
Sure. I guess take us back a little bit into your music background. I guess what made you want to start making music or recording music?
All right. I would say, like, I always loved singing since I was a kid. Like, I just remember singing in the shower, singing in the choir, church choir. I was forced, but I did, like, singing.
Everybody was at first.
Yeah, at one point. But, yeah, I did school choir, but, like, something about it, I don't know, I was just shy. Like, every time it came to doing a solo or singing in front of everybody, I was just like, nope. And then, like, when my parents would, like, hear me sing, I'd be like, y'all ain't hear that. I don't know why. I was just keeping it, like, this big secret. But then I finally just started doing covers. Like, I would say maybe, let's say 2018. That's, like, my freshman year of college age. I'm just like, okay, I do fucks with singing. So let me just do a little cover of my favorite artist, like, and then post some on Instagram. Like, my artist that I like.
Or, like, your first one.
I remember doing one called Triggered by Jhené Aiko, because I had just got out of a relationship, and I was like, fuck it, I'm about to set up my camera in this bathroom. This was when I was like living in Warner Robins, Georgia, so I've really like been through so much, but I feel like singing has always been my refuge through everything, and like eventually maybe somebody, a friend of mine or a mutual friend, like saw me singing and was just like, hey, have you heard of this app called Voicy? And it just had, like, these short little beats. You can sing on it on your phone and just edit your voice. So I just started, this was, like, I say 2022 or 2021, 22, just making a bunch of those. And then that same friend was like, yo, you got a lot of songs on there. You should use BandLab. You at least just have somewhere to put it. Mm-hmm. And I'm glad he said that, because that app closed down, so I could have lost everything.
That's crazy.
They really gave me great advice, so I just went on there, uploaded that, then I was like, oh, hold up, I can just download a little beat and just sing over it. So I finally started making songs that were longer than like 50 seconds, and it just all started, like, it was all step by step. And like when I started performing here in Richmond, I wasn't doing my original songs yet. I was just doing covers and like my poetry. Like my first performance was at Orbital Music Park doing a spoken word poem called Dark Matter. No, actually it was called, it was like a Black Lives Matter poem. So it's been a great 2-year journey. It just unfolded and it's still unfolding. Yeah.
I got one for you. You listed a lot. Like, you do a lot.
No.
I would say, how do you balance it? Or, like, how do you plan throughout, maybe, let's say, like, a week in everything that you do?
I'm going to be real. I'm just now starting to get a little bit more organized. But for a minute, I just be, like, going off straight intuition. Like, okay, let's just make this song. Oh, let me make this jewelry. Oh, well, I know what my podcast is, a schedule on every Monday. So right. I do keep that consistent, like record it like Sunday or Saturday, upload it on Mondays. But as far as everything else in between, it's just like what opportunities are popping up, like for modeling, where's the next model call?
Yeah.
And just like just staying on top of that, putting that in my calendar and just showing up.
It's kind of a first time question for me. I don't know why this popped in my head. you don't have to go too in depth, but like, I guess, how would you say your upbringing formed you to who you are now?
I would say I was raised in a Christian household. I feel like there was high expectations for me. Like, come on now. I was raised as the only child for about 14 years of my life. I'm the firstborn grandchild on both sides. You know, being a young Black woman, like, I just had a whole tribe around me that believed in me and just wanted to see me win, and they wasn't playing with me for real. Like, no, we gotta go hard. Yeah, get that switch, cause we not playing.
What do you think this is?
I ain't gonna lie, I ain't never had a switch.
Hey, no, oh, now, I was like stupid. That was like firewood. You was like,
nice. Oh, it's that fire, all right.
Firewood. I came from the school of, my dad did his, my mom was King Kong with it. She just knows anything. Yeah. And y'all know I like shoes. So yeah, 5, 8, 9, 10. Nike check. I'm like,
I wouldn't say tough, like, it was just high expectations and like not a lot of going out to party, no boys.
What do you need to party for? You need to get them 8 brothers getting out of that. That's true.
Right.
You got a 98 on that quiz, so you don't need to be going off of 98 south to that party. Yeah, it's like,
Pops was going off. Yeah, he was on one that day. He was hurt that day. He had a bad day at work. And now as we get older, we understand he might have had a bad day at work, but he was sitting on. Yeah, he was. He was snapping on you, yeah. 98 South is crazy.
Right.
Yeah. Hold on, bro. Yeah.
Those are just, I had a loving family. Of course, I'm not going to bring up no trauma or nothing. We keeping it light. But just overall, I had a good childhood. I have family that loves me at the end of the day. Yes.
I say this. What makes you one of one from other artists here in Richmond?
One of one. First of all, I'm not even from Richmond. I've been here for about, 2 years? I moved here January 2021. No, for real. So I'm kind of just like popping in as a stranger, but still making a name for myself. And like, I feel like my sound is ever changing and it's constantly expanding. And I don't hear people with my sound, or I just have my own truth to share that maybe some people may have not heard before. Maybe y'all haven't heard my sound. Maybe y'all haven't seen somebody get up stage and play their kalimba. Maybe y'all haven't heard my poetry. Like, I just have a new perspective to bring since I didn't grow up here. So I just kind of have my own ideas, my own sound, and my own vibe that I bring, I believe.
I got one for you.
Okay.
So what do you like to do to recharge? So let's say, you know, you had a really busy week, man. I just want to kind of like, I got an off day. How are you going to relax?
Okay, first of all, I need to be isolated. I need to get away from everything because my social battery probably dead. And
hey, let me talk to you real quick.
Oh, no. No, thank you.
Come on to the family barbecue real quick. Yeah.
Shoot. Yeah, right. If it's food, then that actually might be a great way to recharge.
My language.
Like, just being in my room is just a whole vibe. Like, I can sleep, I can drink some tea, play my music, talk to myself, look in the mirror, do myself some affirmations, journal. Really big on journaling, or just like creating art in any form. I just feel like that recharged me, especially as someone that was, I've been working full time. Like, I need that, and I feel like art of any form has been like an escape for me. But honestly, to recharge my energy so that I can be able to create art, I will also say going into nature has been like my biggest retreat, like going to Browns Island, going to the rocks, and just like zoning out, getting away from everything so that I can just hear God's voice a little better, hear my intuition a little bit better, and just have energy to go out and get everything that I need.
What kind of tea are you drinking on your own?
What kind of tea? I would say I like this tea called Food for the Blood. It actually is really good for women who are menstruating. But I also have this tea that it's mixed with turmeric and ginger. I got it from Calabash Tea in D.C. It's pretty good as well.
They got this kombucha tea place over in Northside that's really good.
Oh, snap. I feel like I heard of that. And they make it there?
Yeah.
Okay, I need to visit that.
I got lemon ginger. That shit is really good.
Okay. Yeah, it's kombucha.
Bojangles sweet tea.
That's y'all's healing tea.
Oh, damn it.
Hey man, you know what? Hey, when we go on that 58, it's gonna be cool. But right, it was bow time. Right. Jesse
went
out. Right,
let me get two mulberry biscuits and a sweet and a large sweet tea.
Two large sweet tea.
Go ahead and throw a 2-piece combo on a biscuit.
Okay.
Yeah.
I got you. We're not gonna take you.
Go ahead.
Okay. No. Okay. If you know us. Okay.
We're one.
No. Okay. Do you eat meat or?
I've been trying to stop for a minute, but I'm just growing up in the South, when you go home and your mom cook a,
facts.
I'm like, no, I'm eating this meat.
That won't be good.
I'm trying to stop,
but yeah.
So, bacon on a cheeseburger. Bacon on a cheeseburger. How you feel about that? Like a bacon cheeseburger?
I'd be like, okay, you know, being on a spiritual journey is hard. Everybody's plant-based, everybody's vegan, but I wouldn't say that's bad, but I would probably feel bad after I eat the bacon cheeseburger. Damn, now you know you're not supposed to eat pig meat.
But do you eat bacon?
I haven't had bacon in 2 weeks.
Okay.
No, you're good. I'm so exposed right now.
You're good.
No, I'm
late. Nick doesn't we all eat meat. It's all the
Yeah.
But he doesn't bacon on cheeseburger. He
says you think it doesn't.
No, he.
Oh, no, it doesn't. No. Well, do you like a bacon, egg, and cheese?
I like bacon by itself.
I've already had an argument about this.
I love bacon by itself, but I need the nastiest thing in the world to put bacon on a cheeseburger. What the hell? I love bacon when I eat it on the side with the eggs, but I hate bacon when it's on a cheeseburger. That I love a cheeseburger. Come on.
Didn't you eat cottage cheese by itself?
Okay. Hold on. We're not going to get that one loaded up.
I'm just saying.
He had that one. Wait, now it's up. I ain't going to lie.
Yeah.
I just quit drawing.
Fair enough. But no.
I'm just saying.
But
you eat cottage cheese by itself.
Hold on.
With a whole spoon.
Hold on. Okay. One time I tried cottage cheese.
But you ate it, didn't you?
I tried.
You
how big was the spoon?
That's a
good
question. How big was the spoon?
Small.
Okay.
You still ate it?
That's not. I have. When I go to, what's it called? Roots. I just sometimes sprinkle a little cottage cheese. No, it's feta. It's feta, actually.
Okay, but cottage cheese, it's usually with vegetables or something that? Or in a tray kind of thing?
Yeah, you dip it with
a little
carrot.
You can put it also in like lasagna and stuff, too.
Oh, right? Yeah.
Like ricotta cheese.
Ricotta, yes.
Ricotta cottage cheese, probably in that family.
Yeah. For real.
Come on, Nick.
I'm not having that conversation.
We don't have to get into it too much, but I mean, if you like bacon, how is
can I put this to bed right now? Let me just put this to bed right now.
Open Pandora's box.
I don't care. I'm not putting bacon on a cheeseburger. I'm not going to eat bacon on a cheeseburger. But I do like bacon by itself. Okay. Now, I'll say this.
But you said that shit was nasty.
Enough.
Go ahead. Continue.
It's nasty.
I digress.
Okay. Now, I'll say this.
I'm listening. I'm right here with you.
You're right. Right here. He's just being up.
I like bread by itself, but put the bun on the burger. I fucking hate that.
We're
shit
done.
With the bun.
We're
go ahead.
Done.
Go ahead. I'm ready. Yeah,
this is going to be an all the time.
All interview. Yes. No.
No. I'll say this.
Hey. I'm now y'all got me acting up.
I'll say this. What got you into poetry?
Oh, I remember. When I moved to Warner Robins, Georgia, I hated it. Basically, I have a military upbringing, so my stepdad was in the military at that time. We moved from Maryland, which I really loved Maryland because it was like diverse. Like the high school I went to, Hammond High School, it was just like so diverse. And I just felt like I was woke at that time. Like I was exposed to like Calabash Tea. You know how I told you about Calabash Tea? Like, when I was a teenager, I was seeing like the beginnings of that because long story short, one of my dad's baby mama's grandmother owns Calabash Tea. So I was just like exposed to like sea moss, herbs, dream interpretation book. And my mom was just like, boom. And that was around the time where like I was getting into good music on SoundCloud. So my mom was just ready. Then there was just a lot going on with the country. There was like a lot of murder against black people, police violence, Trayvon Martin. So I was just like pissed. And I was in the 10th grade English class. We had a project and I forgot my teacher name, but she was just like, we got to write a poem. I forgot what the poem was on, but as soon as they said write a poem, I said, okay. We about to talk about, I named it Recipe for Disaster, which is basically predicting America's downfall. Like, it was basically predicting 2020, because I was basically saying, like, look at all this oppression, look at all this y'all got going on. It's not going to be too long till we rise up. So, like, that poem was so iconic. Like, I ended up being invited to a poetry contest, and like it was just so moving. Like I think it's still on YouTube. I was like 14 years old. Yeah, I was just like,
no, I'm not looking. Oh, nah, yeah, he's playing. Oh, yeah, he's bullshit.
Recipe for Disaster. It was that was the birth of my poetic spirit, and it's still alive.
Somewhat going off of that. If you got, can you give us one conspiracy theory that you have? Yeah. I might start asking you this more. What's one in the box you got?
Okay.
Put us on.
This is a perfect time to ask that because we saw how the first week of 2024 went. Well, all these aliens, UFOs.
Allegedly.
Okay, that's connected to a theory called Project Bluebeam, which I forgot what that man's name was. It's like Sarge Mons.
Don't get us out of here.
I don't want y'all to be shouting that.
Don't get us
up
out of here.
No, this is
23 now.
No, give
we
us
need
the real stuff.
Oh, that is like Lord, part of the real, because Project Bluebeam is saying like, because we have all this advanced AI technology and we can do so much with the holograms and everything, that there could possibly be a fake coming of Christ to cause mass hysteria and chaos and to usher in a new one world government, which turns away from Christ and turns to man and material world. So they want us to be like worshiping this material world instead of Christ. That's not all. Look at how all the celebrities getting called out. Cat Williams called out everybody. All these comedians are sellouts. All these celebrities and artists, why do you think they're dressing as Satan? Like, did you see Lil Nas X dressed as Jesus taking a communion? Like, they're mocking God. This is a part of that one world government. They're targeting the youth with TikTok and all this stuff. All I'm saying is, my conspiracy is, it's called, this theory called New Earth, that a new earth is being ushered in, a new stream of consciousness, a paradigm shift. It's even, if you look up New Earth in the Bible, it's saying like God made new heavens, new earth, like the old world is done. Also, is that camera okay? I think it is. But anyways, I say all this to say I believe in a new earth theory, that the old world is crumbling, that Babylon is falling. I even put that in my song called Return to Nibiru, because I actually predicted that aliens would come in my song Return to Nibiru. And I wrote that like November 2022, the beginning of 2023, all the aliens started coming, and they're still here. So I believe aliens and extraterrestrials, they could kind of be like angels. Maybe not all of them are good, but I just feel like, I mean, definition of angels is like a being that's in the astral plane. So like, maybe they're checking on us like, hey, y'all are wilding out right now, because guess what? Guess what? This human activity that we're doing, the earth is reaching a threshold, meaning the point of no return, meaning if we don't change our ways, if something doesn't stop now, we have 1.9 degrees Celsius of global warming left till we fuck shit up. And there's even doomsday clocks being made. There's scientists that are making this thing called Solar Cycle 25, saying this year, 2024 to 2025, the sun will be very active with the solar storms and the coronal mass ejections, meaning it's a lot of energy coming here on planet Earth from the sun that can interfere with our electromagnetic waves, that can also affect the signal. That could also be the reason why we see chemtrails trying to black out the sun. So I know I said a mouthful. We could really get into it, but I have a lot of conspiracies about why things are the way they are. And like, I feel like it's a good sign that celebrities are being called out and like the evil is being exposed, for sure.
I would almost venture to say like, that might kind of show, like you're saying, like the evil is being exposed. That might kind of show how bad things are, because if it's getting exposed and it's kind of like, oh, like that means that it's so blatant, yeah, that it's like, what you gonna do? Like, you know, kind of thing.
Honestly, why you think they put it in the movies? Like, what was that recent movie? Like, Leave Earth or Leave the Earth Behind.
Oh, yeah.
And stuff like that. It's kind of like they put in it blatant, like, yeah, robots, AI, apocalypse. It's here. And it's just like, what are we going to do? Are we just going to continue living in it? Or are we going to exert that we are a democracy and we can't speak up and say, no, government, y'all can't do that? Or are we just going to keep paying these taxes, keep letting the genocide happen? Like, what are we really going to do here? And sometimes I do feel helpless, because I'm like, yo, what am I going to do in Richmond, Virginia for something that's across seas? But we got to use our voice and we got to make it known, like, this is not okay. We don't stand for it.
Step up, rise up.
Rise up, for real. Use our voice.
Are you stepping up and rising up?
You already know I'm always stepping up.
Wow.
Next question. By rising up.
Last book.
Self-care. Self-care for black men.
Oh, you read it?
Oh.
Yeah, I actually am.
Really?
Yeah, actually am.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I actually have some good words here, so yeah. Appreciate my sister. Yeah, she gave me that for Christmas present, so yeah.
That is so good. I'm actually reading some new books as well. Like, I got this book on New Year's called New Black Woman, and it's just like basically the revolution of today's black woman, who she's healing. She's not dealing with the past. Also, another book called Sacred Pampering Principles for African American Women. That kind of sounds like the female book of what you have. It's just like for self-care.
Yeah.
Because, yeah, sometimes our community doesn't really prioritize self-care. Maybe it wasn't taught to us, or maybe we don't even have the resources. So it's just about learning that, because many other...
Trauma too.
Yes.
Yeah, in our culture here.
We do. We do. And we're healing from all of that. Yeah.
I'd say, kind of still next question. What do you think about the Richmond music scene? I guess positive and negative.
The Richmond music scene... I'm thankful for it, because me moving here in Richmond, I feel like that played a huge role in me getting into music. Like, it definitely did. Like, me getting into the open mic scene, me collaborating with so many artists. Like, it's such a hub for creative expression. And I say all that to say, I feel like me first getting into it was just like rainbows, butterflies, everything's perfect and beautiful. Mm. And then now that I'm like, okay, now you are artists. And now I'm just like... Seeing that I have to move a certain way, seeing that, you know, there is sort of a competitive vibe, but there's also a collaborative vibe. It really depends on who you meet. Mm. It depends on which spaces you go. Some spaces, the whole place will cheer you on, whether you're a good or bad artist. Other places, you could be singing your heart out about to cry. They don't care. So I'm just like, girl. Yeah, like, hey, don't sneeze during the
night. Nah, pass the sauce, right?
They competing with you, yeah. Hey, pass the sauce.
No.
I leave alone. I leave alone. No, I'm just talking in general. Because that be niggas, right? Yeah. I'm niggas, right? Hey, but so you. But, all right, so you know, right? Nah, for sure. You respect everybody, for sure, for sure. And, I guess, yeah, what's one? You said you're negative, or did you say negative?
There's positive and negative. I feel like a lot of creative artists are coming out of Richmond, but that's the thing. Coming out. I feel like this is like the starter hub, like to network, collaborate, build your craft. But like, once you build yourself up as an artist, there's so many other cities out here that we could be going to. And I just want us to think it's bigger than Richmond. Think Atlanta, think Cali, think overseas. Like, it's so much we can do, and we can even be more powerful when we come together too.
Mm.
So I love it. Can't say I love it or hate it. I'm still trying to put my name out there and get to know more people and collaborate and find new spaces and venues to perform and everything. So definitely ups and downs to it.
Sure. I got one more last than yeah, guys. If you had to describe your music, what would you say in a few words?
I would say it's on that spectrum of neo soul, a little bit of alternative R&B. I might sprinkle in a little. Is it called indie pop? I don't know. It's just like a little oomph.
I've heard that before. Yeah.
Like, yeah.
The indie pop, not the oomph. Right, yeah, right, yeah. For clarification. Right, yeah, for sure. Okay.
Yeah, that's how I describe it.
One inspiration. One musical inspiration. Right. The GOAT himself. Anybody that formed, you know.
I really fucks with Willow Smith, and I fucks with her since I was a teenager, and she like got me woke on a lot of stuff because she was like 12 talking about sacred geometry. I'm like, yo, I'm in middle school, like, hold on, wait, let me start learning about the universe. So like, I just love her feel good music. Yes.
But I got scrambling. But we can do a Jesse Wonders real quick and we can get up out of here, man.
Wow. So what does Jesse
Wonders do? And I guess I'm asking you, but we'll all kind of answer. Do you think people do things? Okay, like for instance, let me give you all a story. Not a long story, but my grandma, right? Like you said, she's a church going woman, grandma. Ooh, Lord, yeah, love my grandma. Right? Yeah, all the good stuff. Right. Don't curse, don't nothing, no beer, no drink, no smoke, whatever, right? This nice little sweet grandma, right? No, wait, get out of my house, right? Yeah, so right, love you, death, grandma, all right. So she doesn't speed either, so that's her main thing. So we'll be riding somewhere with her, and she'll be speed limit 45, she's going about a smooth 32. So my granddad, me, my dad, come on, love you to death, grandma. But baby, come on, baby! Oh my God! Like, could you at least go to speed limit? Yada yada yada. Right. And her main thing is, no, y'all. I don't want no ticket. So I just do what I do. I'm putting a little much on. But no, y'all. I don't want no ticket. You know, I mean, let me just drive. You know, I don't want to drive. You know, y'all. I ain't trying to have no trouble. So I see her. I thought about it one day. Does she do that because it's the right thing to do? To not speed, or she doing it because she don't want to get caught? You see what I mean? So, like, going back to my question, do people do things, like, for laws, do people not do things if they don't want to get caught? Or do it because it's the moral thing to do, if that makes sense, kind of. Like,
I'm gonna let y'all go first.
Let it marinate.
Yeah.
So, basically, not do things because they're wrong, or do things because it's the moral.
Yeah.
And like, following the law so you don't get in trouble.
More on the caught side, because niggas can do wrong things and not get caught. But yeah. I say more, is it the fear of not getting, you know, is it the fear of getting caught, or, you know, the repercussions, or is it because, let me not do that?
That's the crazy thing, when you asked that question, the first thing I thought about was like The Purge or something.
Yeah.
He's giving Big Brother.
Yeah, like, so do you not
hey, let me not kill that guy because
like people act, people acted all types of perfect. Mm-hmm. But when that day came, you saw the worst come out in people.
Yeah, like, you know,
so that just means like, do we have laws or people? No, let me not do that. Okay, do niggas not rob bank?
Some you do.
But do I not get up and actually I might give it a fuck. If I can rob a bank with no repercussions, clean, get the hell out. Nobody says nothing, no judgment, no. Honestly, think about it like this. This is a good question. Hold on. Clean walk out the bank, right? No repercussions, but maybe your family is like you're morally wrong. Mm-hmm. You ain't too better than that, Nick. Come on.
I'm gonna be morally wrong with 20 million.
Hell, you know what I mean?
We gonna make it right.
Exactly. Be blessed.
Like,
here you go, my brother.
You're my friend. Go ahead.
Be blessed.
Go ahead, John. Perfect. Oh,
I bet if I replace those countertops and that refrigerator and that bed and that new 2023 Subaru.
All that moral shit out the window.
Exactly. Like,
is this more than that?
Like,
yeah, I think so. This is,
like, think about it. I think about
it. There ain't no fan mail out. Oh, man. Take out the laundry. Santa Claus over there.
I think about it like this. Have y'all, you've seen the show Wu-Tang American Saga?
Of course.
So, it was a point in that show, like, first season, where, like, a couple of the characters were selling drugs, and the mother knew. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, they was keeping food on the table and a roof over their head.
She probably obviously wasn't an advocate for them doing it, but
if
they save.
You know, you helping us out.
Yeah.
So, that moral shit tends to go out.
Whatever, Alex.
I mean, some people keep their morals, but when money is involved, that's when, like, you really got, that moral shit goes out the window when money's involved.
I think I kind of got a take on that. Kind of off of what you said, Nick. That moral shit to a certain extent, like, and then kind of like, I don't want to know, but if you kind of have somewhat of a code, like you could do something not morally.
Yeah,
but
you could do like something absolutely horrible.
Obviously, situations.
Yeah.
But I get what you're saying now. You could be, okay, like for instance, like Nick said, they were, you know, selling drugs or whatever.
Right.
But like, if you watch the show or whatever, they still had somewhat moral, or street morals. You know,
yeah, street morals. Yeah, street code.
There's morals in whatever you do. Like,
right.
So, yeah.
So if you kind of like, what is it like? Kind of like ethics and that kind of thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, so if it's like you're like following that, and then this can be a slippery slope. But if your intentions are good, you know, so if you have good intentions and you can kind of stick with that moral code, my intentions are.
I really thought like you can't do all you can't. There's a line, I guess.
Yeah.
You need to say that line.
But see, I don't like. Okay.
We'll let you go, Diamond. So I think it's marinated.
I want to say like as far as morals go, like we have a moral code, like right and wrong in our psyche, like, you know,
allegedly.
Not everybody, because, you know, psychopaths and all that kind of stuff, sociopaths, that kind of thing, but one say we all kind of somewhat have a conscience, so we know like right from wrong kind of thing, or we're at least taught it,
at least according to you, like
so you probably would have at least heard of it, Yeah, that's a tough one. But what the question was, would we like kind of like her?
No, I guess it's just kind of open-ended.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like, what do you lean more? So y'all say, well, that has a dime, what you say? There's no definite answer.
I would say, like, laws are set in place because I feel like humans know that us humans, we can get a little crazy, so it's just kind of like the checks and balances in place so that we don't do something, and if we do something wrong, there are repercussions. And then it comes to this global ethics thing, well, what do people do if they're in poverty? They need to go out and get it. Like, they might have to step on some toes. So really, I saw this to say, you could be following all your ethical and moral codes and still you could accidentally do something wrong or hurt somebody's feelings or speed above the speed limit. Like, it's just all these things in place just to keep us in check at the end of the day.
So that kind of leans me towards, it's kind of a little bit of both. Mm-hmm. Because, like, I've heard, like, what we're, someone was saying this, where we're, like, behavioral. So, like, we're, like, okay, like, we learn from, like, rewards and consequences. Like, so when things happen, and it's like, oh, you shouldn't have done that, I'm going to do this. And then it's like, oh, I'm
school. Like,
parents, getting away. Guess what this is. I was definitely, I was like, I was smooth, like,
But I don't want to go too deep in that. So if y'all see us with some money, you know what I mean, just know our ethics and
our intentions were to get paid.
At the end of the day,
we took y'all's money.
If Molly can do it, if Hannah can do it, if Molly and Hannah can do it, like, then my black ass, no, you can't. Like, no, you will not be.
Your Honor, I'd like to pay for the
bail.
Your Honor, I think I can cover the bail. You son of a bitch.
Sure.
Your Honor, reach in my bag. I think that'll cover the bail. Yeah, yo.
Did you see the video of the dude that jumped over the
He leaped.
Yeah, you saw that. Yeah.
So that was iconic.
Bro.
Really iconic.
Nah, L security. What's the dude? Bailiff or whatever it is to get? L, bro. Stop. L, bro.
Clear.
Yeah. No, you know. You know what they were saying? Oh, they was like, bro, it's Troy Father Molly.
Oh, yeah.
Jumping over the line. I was like, y'all niggas are so dumb, bro. That
hardest nigga
in his prime. And we all know how high them damn judge things are. So. Nah, but L, everybody.
They scrolling on their phones.
According to the video, she didn't even say the sentence yet. You know how that's how it usually go. Oh, 50 years. Oh, whatever. No, she was like, duty or something. I have to give you jail time.
That's not going to slide
As she's saying it. No, fuck that.
Yeah.
Troy Father Molly.
Like, so they sat there and saw him.
Super Bowl champion,
jump in his
head. Nah, L courtroom. L. Okay, you know, and I got one more for you. We gotta go. But. Y'all see that dumbass shit happen in Virginia courtroom? Y'all see that shit happen? Imagine. What? Imagine doing that on Pelham Road. Right? Yeah. Imagine doing that on Courthouse Road. And talk about, boy, what? Yeah, you're not going to push it. Don't push it. Because if they can't grab you, I didn't know what to do. You stood on business the first time, man. Nah, you definitely said it, nigga. Let's go ahead and wrap this up. And then that hurts. Real quick, we could do announcements and we can get up out of here. Diamond, any shout outs, any announcements you want to say to the people before we get up out of here?
Shout out to anybody that supports my art and my music. Shout out to any of my listeners or anybody who's interested in purchasing my jewelry. Shout out to my family. Thank y'all for giving birth to me. Shout out to God. Shout out to every single human that's watching this. Shout out to y'all.
Obviously, thank you, Diamond, for coming through. Yeah, I mean, been in the works for a minute. After the last topic, I'm a little dazed, but shout out J1Day1 Films. Hey man, Chain Reaction. short film made by the guys here. Thank you. Thank you for the support, man. We've been seeing a lot of people tap in, tune in, so we do appreciate it. My dad wasn't even hitting me up about it, right? I was like, wow. So just type shit, right? The morals, right? Yeah. But we're gonna keep going though. That's the main thing. Y'all know how we are, but appreciate everybody that was in it. Shout out to Miko. Appreciate you, brother. I know you had all them dates. He was like, bro, we gotta shoot again. Like, yeah, we know, bro. But everything came out pretty fire. Should have new clips coming out, yada yada yada. But yeah. So subscribe, man. That's really the main thing. Nick.
First off, I want to say shout out to all the black men and women, mothers, fathers. It's 2024. It's time to snap on niggas this year. Let people know how you really feel. It's all that hate and anger that you build up. Let that shit out. You know, because I know niggas is getting tired of other people. Other than that, shout out documentary. It's coming soon.
Man.
Shout out Richmond Times Dispatch. Yes.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Your boy was in the newspaper.
I'm going to just overclap. Yeah. I'm going to just go over the next trigger with that.
Shout out, how about this? Everybody go into the dictionary and learn some new words. How about that? I'm tired of seeing everybody use misogyny in the wrong way on my Twitter timeline. Let's go learn some new words. Let's go learn some new
words.
There are
It takes no longer than
30 minutes to go look up
rotunda.
Other words. Trust me. And that word that you use all the time, they have other words.
That's synonyms.
Exactly.
No, let me leave them alone.
Remember, eat breakfast, drink water, all that good shit.
Introspective.
How's it going? What? Go ahead.
Y'all, I ain't going to hold y'all too long. All I'm going to say is, what you need, y'all got, you have to. At this point, come on, y'all. You are sitting at home. You're laying in bed. Jesse, where do they have their hand? They got their hand on their W-2s, their 1099-Rs, 1099-NECs, miscellaneous, 2020 and 2021 stimulus letters. So what do they need to do, Jesse?
Well, first of all, I got turned down to Diamond Chanel because, the police hating, you know, they don't like this good spiritual music that I'm bumping out my speakers, right. I'm sliding through Hall Street and where am I? Southside Plaza, I think. Where am I going?
You're going to 2650 Hall Street Road, 2650 Hall Street Road, Fiscal, Fitness, Tax, and Financial Services. My father's business, Derek L. Alford, been doing taxes over 30 years, y'all. And Nick, you might catch your boy in there. You might catch your boy in there doing a little something. Tighten up. Very professional. Handle our business. We stand on business. He can set you up with retirement planning, any kind of financial help, get you set up with the annuity, and also, of course, do your taxes. And we don't just do taxes for individuals. We also do business taxes, y'all. So we got you. All you new business owners or business owners for a long time, you need to switch over or whatnot. We can definitely get you taken care of, and we can even get you in contact with somebody to get you taken care of if it's something that we don't do. So let us know. The number is 804-321-5766. That's 804-321-5766, y'all. Yeah. And shout out to J1 Day 1 Films. Diamond, thank you for coming on. Yeah, appreciate it.
Thank y'all. This is really cool.
What's that? Nick, keep doing your thing, my brother. Documentary going to blow up. About to take over the city. About to take over the world.
Maybe even the Milky Way galaxy.
Facts. Maybe some other galaxies surround him. Yeah, you never know.
All right. Thank you, Diamond Chanel, for coming through. We appreciate it. I'm Nick.
Jesse. Alex.
And this was the 804 Podcast.
And we are out of here.